Hi, my name is Dr. Tuesday Hambric, and I am a psychology professor, and I teach our student success classes at Dallas College. When you're looking at the student's perspective, and you're trying to figure out what is the best approach to reaching the students and helping them learn the student success material so that they can then in turn be successful in other classes, what I bring to the table is not only am I addressing the student's perspective, but I've expanded that in a very effective way so that not only are they being successful in other classes, but they're going to use a universal approach to be successful in their personal lives as well as their careers. Because as we know, our students can have the will to be in school and the desire to be in school and in their classes and to do well. But as soon as life happens, if they do not have coping skills or the tools that they need to think with quality thoughts so that they can follow through with quality behaviors, they find themselves focusing more on the outside world than the academic world. And so that's another thing that I bring to the table is one, students' perspective, truly addressing the students' perspective, and then two, giving them universal tools that they can use in not just their personal life, but in other aspects of their life that actually will affect their academic life. One of the things that I bring to the table to help the students really get their desired approach to learning is that I wrote the textbook in first person. So let me just back up a little bit there. I did a little research to find out what it is exactly the students want to know. Why do they want to know those things? And what is their desired way of learning? And I wanted to go outside of the typical hands-on auditory learner and those types of approaches, because what I find is that the students learn that in high school. And not only do they learn it in high school, they're not given, after learning that, they're not given the tools that they need to expand that into more advanced ways. And so after doing a little research with the students and conducting a small qualitative study to deduce from all that data what is it is that the students want, I created this textbook, number one, from first person perspective. And so remember I said earlier, what's missing is the student's perspective. So I wrote the book in first person perspective so that I could have a conversation with the student. And so I call it conversational style writing. So many publishers were like, yeah, I'm not going to get on board with that Tuesday. Textbook should be written in third person. And what they missed out on, and Kendall Hunt quickly jumped into, was this notion that I'm having a one-on-one dialogue with the students, which is what I am all about. Easy. I'm very detailed because I feel like learning should be in fragments, if you will, and then strung together into larger and bigger pictures. But I'm also about easy. And so I am the, or shall I say, I'm the former chair for our learning framework program. And what I found is that I needed to quickly create a faculty pool so that I wouldn't have last minute hirings, and that puts the faculty members under a lot of stress being given a classroom, the material all in one day, and then telling them, oh, by the way, your class starts tonight. And so what I did to make this much easier for those types of situations is not only do we have the curriculum that stands alone, the textbook by itself can be given to any student, even in a self-paced setting, and they will get a dynamic experience because I am actually teaching the pros and cons of different things within the textbook, as well as giving them ideas about where they may be on track, off track, and how to get back on track if they are off track, and so on. And then there's lessons inside of there, so they would get a very dynamic learning experience. With that said, I've also added the PowerPoints. Now you say, well, that's not different. Everybody has PowerPoints and test bank questions and so on. In the PowerPoint, I have under each PowerPoint in the notes section, I have instructions on how to approach that particular PowerPoint. And then that is then strung together to a collection of PowerPoints. So each unit is designed so that you can see the bigger picture with the PowerPoints, but also every time you click a PowerPoint, you can study at home before you get into the classroom, how you can quickly make that PowerPoint have a more larger meaning, as well as a particular meaning for that classroom, that moment, that time. And so basically it's like putting the teacher's manual in the PowerPoints, but being more specific and more deliberate about it, along with learning objectives, universal student learning outcomes that will fulfill not just academic growth, but also career growth and personal growth as well. So those are some of the things that I've done that I've added to the curriculum, the textbook itself, to make teaching it very easy. Again, having a textbook that is self-sustaining, adding in PowerPoints that have instructions in the bottom of the PowerPoint, so easy access, not dealing with several different resources. And then also we have a test bank. Everybody loves test bank. But then I also added a pre and post test. Now, some other curriculums may or may not have a pre or post test, but my pre and post test is strategic. It is very much designed around critical thinking, and it measures six different levels of thinking within Bloom's taxonomy. And it is a pre and post approach. So in other words, the students will come into the classroom, they will take the pretest, and they will get an idea of what their critical thinking skills are like and abilities prior to treatment, if we're gonna speak, say, scientific language, prior to any treatments. After the class, after they've learned the lessons and gone through the material, at the end of said treatment, then they will take the post test and they get to see for themselves, and not just see it, but appreciate the evidence of their growth and their ability to think and process information on six different levels. And not only do the pre and post tests measure critical thinking skills on these six different levels, it also measures those universal student learning outcomes as well. So those are some of the things that I add that are already pre-set for you. All you have to do is download everything and you are all set. I would love to invite anyone that is interested in adopting Unlock Your Mind to Academic and Life Success to please go ahead and contact John Baird or myself, Tuesday Hambric, and I will be more than happy to come out and conduct trainings with you and your faculty members, and that way you can get hands-on real life experiences, walk and have me walk you through the different cooperative learning setups, the different material in the textbook, the activities that come along with the textbook and things like that. I would love to do that. And so outside of that, I would just like to say thank you for spending time with me.